Gwe, Nindaluisi Darcy. Hello, my name is Darcy. I would like to acknowledge that the performance you are about to see was recorded in Mi'kma'ki, the traditional and unceded territory of the Mi'kmaq people. If you are watching this from outside of Mi'kma'ki, I invite you to learn about and honor the indigenous nations on whose territory you reside. Wel'aliak. Thank you.
Thank you so much for tuning in again to our online encores. This week, we're looking at Mozart 34, which we did earlier this season. It's a beautiful piece, and it was a lovely way to open a concert. It's only three movements. It's quite short. The outer two movements are very optimistic and joyful and sort of like bright morning sunshine, really forward-looking and full of propulsion and momentum. And they sit either side of a middle movement, which, like most middle movements, is slower, but it's not colder, it's not sadder, it's still sunshine, but it's like late afternoon sun. It's got that warm glow to it. It's far more still and intimate and tender. And it was a really nice piece to work on with the orchestra because, well, first of all, it was our second concert together, so we were starting to get to know each other and be able to really test the parameters of our relationship musically. But also, as a movement, there's enough space between the notes that you can really place things and take care of things, and it really pay attention to small details and wait until you've heard them before responding with your lines. So it was a really lovely, really lovely piece to play. After that, as with all of our online encores, I'll be having a discussion with two of our players, and I've asked Max, who is principal bass, and Gabe, who is the bassoonist, to chat with me about the piece. And I chose them because, well, Gabe didn't actually have a part in his pad for this, but at the time, bassoonists would have played along with the double bass. It was a continuo instrument, so they would have been part of the low, rich balance in the string section, which stops it being too top heavy. And it was great. He just kind of sight read it on the spot and immediately got into the spirit of it. So I wanted to talk to them both. And also two bass instruments, because we think a lot as an audience and even as performers about the melody when we're listening to classical music. But actually, the far more interesting stuff is going on in the bottom and in the middle. So it's really interesting to think about a work like a Mozart symphony that's built, you know, its building blocks are harmony, not melody so much, and talk to two bass instruments who really are the drivers of that harmony and the harmonic drive and the harmonic structure that's their bread and butter. So I hope we'll have some enormous insight from those two players for you afterwards. See you then.
Thank you.
Bye.